Hey everybody, it's Jeff again. Welcome back. Are you ready to have some fun? Yeah, me too. Okay, fun fact about me. I absolutely love to discover new things. For example, I love finding out that your favorite color is... Yes, I love that color too. I love discovering that your favorite kind of pizza is... But so is pepperoni, right? And it's so interesting that your favorite animal is... Mine has lots of fur. Does yours? I love it. When you take a closer look and really focus on something, you can discover a lot more about it. Like now, I know something new about you. The same thing is true about God. We may not be able to see God with our eyes, but as we discover how good He is, that helps us to trust Him more and more. Right now, I want to see how well you can focus with another game. Today, we have a new special guest with us. My friend, Mr. Rob, is going to join us. Hey, Rob!
Whoa! Whoa! Hey, Jeff! Wow, thanks for inviting me to be here. I am so excited today. Hey, kids, are you ready to play a game with me? Yeah? All right, let's do it. Now, it's called the Focus Cup Shuffle. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take this ball, all right? I'm gonna put it under one of the cups. When I start to shuffle the cups around, keep your eye on the ball. At the end, you're gonna try to guess which cup is covering the ball. Are you ready? All right, let's focus. Here we go. All right, do you think you know where the ball is? All right, let's find out. Did you pick this cup? Let's see. No! How about the middle cup? Oh no, if you picked this cup, you got it right. Good job. All right, you wanna try it again? All right, we're gonna try it again, and this time, I'm gonna go a little bit faster, so make sure you focus, all right? Here we go. All right, now let's see where the ball is this time. You ready? Okay, you know where it is? Is it under this cup? Let's see. There it is! If you got the center cup, you picked right. Good job. Okay, we're gonna try it one more time, one more round, and this time, we're gonna go at super, super duper speed. You ready to focus on the ball? You ready? Here we go. Put it under the cup, shuffle. You think you know where he is? All right, let's find out. Ready? Let's try. How about, did you pick the center cup? Let's check. Oh, no, so close. How about this cup? This one? Which one? We'll try this one? All right. Oh, you did it. If you picked this cup, you got it right. Good job. That was tough because it was so fast. Now, if you got at least one right, give yourself a hand. No, really, you deserve it. Give yourself a hand. It was awesome. Now, you know what? Let's keep the enthusiasm going with some music. It's one really great way we can put our focus on God by singing and praising Him together. Let's do that right now. Come on, everybody, let's stand up.
You made the sky above, you made the oceans deep. Hello! Hey! Hey! Where are you right now?
Yee-haw!
You're hearing all of these sounds and it's taking you on a journey, maybe to the wild, wild west, all because of what you're hearing. Sound is so important to the way we interact with the world. Here, I'll show you why. Okay. The gnome. It's a gnome. Okay. I'm sorry if we spooked you. But we could do this because of one reason only. You didn't hear us coming. Sure, okay, you saw us coming. You saw Charlie here. This is Charlie. I named him Charlie, he's a gnome. You saw Charlie fall right onto the table, but we were able to give you a little jump scare because we process sound faster than we process sight. Even though the speed of light,
299,792,458 meters per second,
is faster than the speed of sound.
A measly 340.29 meters per second.
Wait, hold on. So you're saying the gnome, even though I saw it hit the table, I didn't hear it at the same time?
Hold on, check it out. So, we see Charlie fall onto the table, but what we see doesn't reach our brain until about a little less than a quarter of a second.
Really?
Yeah.
Like, now, 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 now.
Yes, yes.
Now, now.
As opposed to sound, which gets to our brains faster at 0.05 seconds.
No, 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 no
So why is that? Well, we're going to be talking all about that and more today on A Closer Look.
Actually, I think they get the point.
Oh, no, you think? Kyle, when are we going? Kyle? Where did Kyle go?
I'm not sure. I was busy counting to 0.05 of a second. It's very taxing.
I got you again. I got you again.
Oh, how exhilarating.
Why would you do that?
To illustrate a point about how our brains process sound faster than processing vision. I mean, did either of you see me coming?
Of course not! You snuck up on us!
Well, the camera saw me. Everyone out there saw me.
Why didn't you warn us?
I mean, imagine if you were out in the world picking berries or something.
La 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 la. Oh, what a beautiful day. I'm sure nothing bad could possibly happen in the great wide world.
Rawr, I'm a wolf.
Yeah! Curses! A wolf! If only I had a sense that could warn me when someone was sneaking up on me.
Acting aside, that's the point. We can only see in front of us, but we can hear everywhere.
All I wanted to do was bake a pie.
Too bad for my buddy over there. Sound waves are hitting us all the time. But what about sound waves we can't hear? More on Closer Look after this.
Does anybody have any floss? Got a little berry stuck in my teeth.
All right, so if I knock down the kitchen wall right there, then, oh yeah, then that leads to the bedroom. And then, oh, and that way I don't have to get out of the bed to go to the fridge. Oh, hey everyone. So I got a set of blueprints right here. Blueprints are basically a drawing of a building before it's built. Or maybe like the instructions to your Legos. They help tell the builder how to build something so that the building makes sense. Now, if you're sitting in a building right now, it was designed by someone who drew up a plan. Then they gave that plan to a builder so that they knew exactly how to build the building so that it would be the right size and that it would be safe to go in and out of and have enough bathrooms. Really? Pretty much any building you go into had a lot of thought go into it before it was built and had a blueprint. Well, except for that fort I built when I was 5, definitely didn't have blueprints. Yeah, that one had no thought going into it. But our Bible story today comes from the book of Matthew, and it talks about building our lives on a solid footing. Now, let's say you can't see these plans very well here. What if it was out of focus? It would be pretty hard to see how to put together the building. That's kind of what our Bible story talks about today. It comes from the book of Matthew, and it's something that Jesus said. He said, "So then, everyone who hears my words and puts them into practice is like a wise man. He builds his house on the rock. The rain comes down, the water rises, the winds blow and beat against that house, but it does not fall. It is built on the rock. But everyone who hears my words and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man. He builds his house on the sand. The rain comes down, the water rises, the winds blow and beat against that house, and it falls with a loud crash." So, I have two model houses here. The first one, my friends and I are gonna build on a pile of sand. All right, here goes nothing. Woo, all right. This sand is making it really difficult. It's impossible to get this thing level. Okay, well, it's standing at least, but let's try to build it on rock and see how it turns out. Now, that is a house. Alrighty, now it's time for the storm. Not bad. Not bad at all. And now, for this guy. Well, there you go. Yeah, it's pretty clear which house we'd want in the storm. Jesus told his disciples that whoever puts his words into practice is like the wise man. Now, what does that mean for us today, 2,000 years later? Jesus isn't exactly standing right in front of us to tell us what to do. But here's a couple of things that I think are pretty exciting. We have the Bible. And in the Bible, there are these four books right at the beginning of the New Testament that we call the Gospels. And the Gospels were written by people that either knew Jesus or by people that talked to people that hung out with Jesus. And they wrote down some incredible things that Jesus said. So even though we can't see Jesus, we can see his words and we can put them into practice. Your Bible is a book full of wisdom and stories that shows us a better way to live. And most importantly, the Bible points to Jesus. If we believe in Jesus, God will give us his very spirit to live inside of us. Crazy, right? And God's Holy Spirit inside of us can help us make wise choices and can help us selflessly love the world like Jesus did. And so, in some ways, the Gospels and the words of Jesus are like these blueprints. Right here. The Gospels can help you focus on who Jesus is, and the stories of Jesus can give you some really great ideas on how to love the world around you, how to love your brother or sister, how to be kind to your friends, or even how to love someone that others look down on. That's pretty incredible. That 2,000 years after Jesus walked on the earth, we can still read his word, and even though he's not standing right in front of us, we can hear from God. I'll see you again soon, and we'll keep taking a closer look. I have some houses to get wet.
Wilson!
Samantha! What do you got there, buddy?
It's a whistle, but it's broken.
Let me see that. It's broken. Well, we've done all we can do.
Whoa, Kyle! Not so fast, Wilson.
It's broken. We can throw broken things away. That's our right as scientists.
Okay, first of all, that is totally not true. And second, it's not broken. There's only a certain spectrum of sound that we can hear. See, the whistle's not broken. We just can't hear the sound that it makes.
Why would anybody make a whistle you couldn't hear?
For dogs. Hey, boy! Oh, see, this is my dog, Puplo Picasso. He loves people. He really does.
So
you're
cute.
Such a good
Let's
boy.
Go. Hey, come on. Let's go.
There are so many sounds that we can't hear. In fact, as we get older, our ears don't really work as well as they used to. So there are some sounds that people only under 25 can hear. So check this out.
I don't hear anything.
Ow! What is that sound?
Oh, no, I mean, yeah, there it is. We both hear that sound that hurts our ears
what
so
are you
bad.
Doing? The sound stopped.
Well, yeah, I mean, obviously. I know that. We know that because we're both young and cool and hip.
There are all sorts of sounds all over the spectrum. It's amazing to think that that this and this and even this, they're all just vibrations in the air. Okay, what are some of your favorite sounds?
Oh, I like the sound a basketball makes when it goes through the hoop. That's delicious.
I love the sound of a high five.
Ooh.
Oh, yes.
That's awesome. Okay, what person do you like to hear from?
Oh, I love to hear from my granny. I feel like I can still hear her singing to me when I close my eyes.
You are my Samantha. My
oh, that's lovely, Samantha. Samantha.
You make me
I like hearing my cat snore.
Yes, so cute. I just want to mush your face up against my face until we have the same face and we're the same person, dude.
I love my cat. She's adorable and I love her and she's a cutie.
Okay, well, what about you? Who do you like to hear from the best? And what are some of your favorite sounds? They can be like this, or this, or even this. Whatever noise you pick, there are no wrong answers because all of our eardrums are made differently. Just like all of us, we're all made differently. So to pick out all those little differences, all you gotta take is a closer look.
This is my faith, this is my focus, all of my days, I know where my hope is, I live it loud, I shout the chorus, because I'm no, oh, you're always for us, and even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, believe, and even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, and keep on looking. I know where my hope is. I live it loud. I shout the chorus because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you. I will believe, believe. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you. I will believe and keep on looking. For where I'm going, no, you go there too. I'll keep on looking, looking, looking to you. I'll fix my eyes.
Go. Hands in the air, hands in the air. you.
Everybody say yes, yes, to VBS.
To be wise, we've got to focus on what's important. We can do that by reading the Bible. When we hear the words Jesus said and put them into practice, we build our lives on a solid foundation that will never ever fail. Remember, you can hear from God. In these pages, you can read about the amazing things Jesus said and did. You can find out how God sent Jesus to be the Savior of the world, and you can even take the next step. You can put Jesus's words into practice and show his love to the people around you. Just think about that for a second. How do you know what God wants you to do? Talk about that with whoever's there with you, and I'll see you next time.